विद दिस इट ब्रिंग्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन. हमारा बेसिक फंडामेंटल क्लियर हो गया कि फुल स्टैक डेवलपर क्या होता है. ठीक है, अब एक रेगुलर डेवलपर मतलब एक रेगुलर सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर और आईटी और ईएनटीसी एंड अ फुल स्टैक डेवलपर में क्या डिफरेंस होता है फ्रॉम अ कंपनी परस्पेक्टिव. एंड आई थिंक इट बिकम्स अ वेरी ग्राउंड वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग ग्राउंड फॉर ओंकार एंड शरद टू टॉक अबाउट द माइंडसेट व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड ड्यूरिंग प्रिपरेशन एंड व्हिच इज रिक्वायर्ड वंस यू एंटर द कंपनी. So maybe you can explain this slide before Omkar and Sharad speaks about their experience and the mindset. Yes, Pran, please go ahead.
Yeah, so basically this is some common example actually that is available on the web as well. So if we just so I so some parameters are mentioned here, and we have this full stack column and the regular engineer, basically the engineer who works on C, C++, okay, that kind of language. So first of all, this is basically the accessibility. So the full stack developer, so basically he work on any part of the web, okay. So web by web mean doesn't mean that only website, okay. So it could be a web application mostly, okay, because most of the company basically use web apps nowadays instead of desktop app kind of thing, okay. So full stack developer is someone who has to work on any part, who can work on any part of the web. But in regular engineer, basically he has to work on some specific application. For example, let's say a C++ developer who work on some particular part, okay. So he will join a company to work on that particular part only, and after that, when he gain 2 to 3 years of experience, he will be definitely become a master, but still will work on that particular part only, because he become a master of that particular part only, okay. And the interaction time parameter, you can say definitely, since a full stack developer has to work with different technologies, so that's why he need more, he will get the opportunity to interact with more people in the team. But regular engineer, like, see, the job area is relatively small, so that's why definitely it's less interaction he will get, and the domain part. So here's the domain part. It is basically an important thing actually. So for like follow comprehensive access for the buildup of product. So whenever, let's say, a new product that the company is going to launch, so in that case, the full stack developer, so it's just an example, okay. So full stack developer can simply do some brainstorming, like what are the technologies we should use and how we are going to build that software, okay. And it is only possible when you have the vast knowledge, okay. What's happening, like, and definitely, and you have to update yourself as well, okay. But if you check this regular engineer, so see, whenever a company, let's say, want to build a new product from scratch, okay, and an engineer who only has the knowledge of a particular part of C++, let's say, okay, do you think that whatever what he said, like, okay, we can build the software using this way, or we should use this technology, who will listen to him? Because he has the knowledge of this part only, he don't know about anything else. But when it comes to full stack developer, he know the front end, back end, API, database, and deployment. So basically the entire thing. Even if needed, a full stack engineer can build an entire product solely. Okay. So that's why people will listen to his voice. Okay. And the work, basically, see, work we already discussed in the text section, like we will work on everywhere, and he will work on a particular part, a role. A team, so definitely he will most of the time they head a team because they have the knowledge of everything. So now let's say a member who is good in front end and another member who is good in back end, so you can simply lead them, okay, like this is the best approach. So back end team, you should do this kind of work, front end team, you should do this kind of work, and product, yes, definitely. So the full stack developer mostly create different web application nowadays. Almost every software has their web version. Okay. But in regular engineer, basically build desktop apps, that kind of stuff. Okay. And salary, definitely, since a full stack developer work on different section, his job area is bigger than a regular engineer. So definitely salary will be higher than the regular engineer. And all this information are available in Google. feel free to do Google search and everything to confirm.
Sure, absolutely. I think Pranveer, what you have done over here is aapne bahut acha base taiyar kiya hai for our course mentors to talk about the mindset from the industry perspective. The first question would be, so when a student, third year, final year engineering student, Sharad, wants to get into a technology field such as full stack developer, so during preparing for that particular course, what kind of mindset is required as a student? So you can imagine the students are from non-IIT, non-NIT zone, which means they have to work on their academics, obviously, because academic degree is important. But what kind of mindset is required when you are looking to enter into the full stack development?
Yeah, great question, Rohit. See, being a full stack engineer, first of all, you need to understand the first front end as well as back end, right? When I say it sounds very simple, but if you try to understand it, it's not that simple, because front end has whole gamut of technologies, so the back end, right? So, you know, irrespective of your streams, guys, you know, you need to understand a couple of things very clearly. You cannot master something unless until you know it, right? So if you want to become a full stack engineer, it's very important for you to understand how software works. See, if you understand one programming language very well, it's very easy to switch to another programming language. But what is important, the most important aspect of this is you need to understand it in and out of that programming language, be it front, you know, be it the most basics of, you know, the Java or PHP, or you want to take a kind of a framework. So the backend also, it's very important for you to understand how database works. Well, before you understand how database works, you need to understand how, you know, operating system works, because after all, everything runs on top of operating system. So what I see, you know, the kind of mindset that is needed for a, you know, a person to become a full stack engineer is to have that, you know, the basic understanding, the fundamentals has to be very strong. You should know at what point of time you should be having a, you know, a memory object which should be keeping all your data, or you should be pushing everything to database, right? And that kind of knowledge you can only have when you have a complete understanding of how the whole thing works. If you push it to database, how many cycles it will increase, you know? So that's very important. That's essential, you know?
So I think what you are highlighting is a very important point, Sharad, and I would paraphrase what you said, is first, language तो सीख लोगे आप, और पर पॉइंट ये है कि लैंग्वेज सीखने के साथ साथ जो जरूरी है वो ये कि सॉफ्टवेयर काम कैसे करता है.
एट
द एंड ऑफ द डे हाउ डज अ सॉफ्टवेयर फंक्शन. इन अनदर टर्म, एक सिंपल सी बात है कि बिजनेस रन कैसे होता है ये पता होना चाहिए. आजू बाजू चीजें आप सीख लोगे, बट प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड हाउ डज अ बिजनेस फंक्शन. सो सिमिलर वे, हाउ डज अ सॉफ्टवेयर फंक्शन, एंड इन ऑर्डर टू नो हाउ डज अ सॉफ्टवेयर फंक्शन, योर फंडामेंटल्स नीड टू बी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग. दैट्स व्हाट यू आर सेइंग. And you also said one very interesting point, that knowledge of operating system, database, these things are very, very integral beyond coding. Because, you know, and this is exactly what I have also seen. Jab bhi main students se baat kar raha hu, we talk to 300 students every day. Usme se aap maan ke chalo 100 students computer science ke hote hain. Sabko pata, sabko ye hum jo sunte rehte hain aaju baaju mein, ki programming seekhni hai. And people are just learning programming center, left, right. Python, एक Python सीख लिया, किसी ने JavaScript सीख लिया, पर वो जुड़ते कैसे हैं? How does it perform in a software? Nobody teaches it. And when you sit for an interview of a fresher engineer, high paying, then these questions are asked, and then the students start thinking कि ये तो पता ही नहीं है.
Correct.
So I think you have kind of opened a very interesting point and Pandora's box by mentioning this point. So thank you so much for setting up this platform for the mindset. Mindset ka matlab operating system, mindset ka matlab database, mindset ka matlab fundamentals, and definitely isko hum kehte hain algorithmic mindset. You need to know how does an algorithm functions rather than only about the language.
Yeah.
Which brings me to the second point, Sharad, second question. इज एक हो गया प्रिपरेशन, पर जब हम ये सीखकर एज अ फुल स्टैक इंजीनियर कंपनी में जाते हैं शरद, तो कंपनी में पहले 2 साल क्या माइंडसेट होना चाहिए कि आप नजर में आओ और आपका जो करियर है पहले 2 साल एक सर्टन ग्राफ रहे, आप रेगुलर लोगों से हटके रहो, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ माइंडसेट इज रिक्वायर्ड एट दैट टाइम?
सी आई मीन द मोस्ट अगेन आई वुड गो बैक टू द सेम पॉइंट राइट वी हायर when I was with Oracle, I used to hire, you know, every day there was one or two hiring. And here at iAssist also, we are hiring every month. We are going to all different institutes, based on the needs. And then based on, you know, we hire. But what is important for a person to shine in the, you know, the kind of work a person does, the approach he or she takes, right? And how can you take a good approach? Most of the people, and I'm not generalizing it, but this is my experience. Most of the people I have seen, they just learn the language. They don't understand it, right? If you understand it, then you can play with it, right? And that's where it defines, you know, it differentiates between an ordinary person who would do the basic programming or a person who would do, you know, something which is extraordinary. So if you want to have a very good career in software side, you need to understand this very well. How to go back to the basics, making sure that you understand it. Your approach is always, as you correctly mentioned, algorithmic approach. So you need to understand one backend very well, you know, how operating system works. One language you should master completely. And you should know the different types of algorithms that are available, right? How to approach, you know, many of you are, I'm sure that you would be from computer science also, right? So yeah. What is binary tree? What is merge sort? You would be thinking it is just something theoretical, right? Most of the people, they don't use it. But the people who remember it and they use it at later point of time in their career. And those guys are the guys who actually shine, you know, in their work.
No, I think well said once again, Sharad. I think great points. Again, to paraphrase what you said, is the approach is what the mindset makes the person different in the first 2 years of an individual's career. How do you approach a problem during the interview? How do you approach the problem within the work life? And are you able to, provide solution rather than finding a problem within the problem? Are you able to provide a solution to your peers, to your superiors? Do you have that ability to, you know, have that kind of approach in finding a solution to the problem rather than only talking about the problem? So I think very well said, Sharad. And once again, thank you for your time. Thank you for these two very important inputs. My takeaway after listening to you would be, if I am a student, one is the approach, which is an algorithmic approach. And the second one is, please understand how does a software functions rather than only talking about the language. Please understand that, and that will help you to prepare better for a course like this. And obviously that will take your career to the next level.